Has Reddit become a place where celebrities and big brands benefit from free advertisement while the average Redditor who wants to share a personal project gets shooed away? I'd like to talk about Reddit and self-promotion. It's a rabbit hole of a topic I found myself tumbling down this past week based on a personal experience. Here's the too long didn't watch. I made a website that I think is kind of cool. When other Redditors see it, they tend to like it and upvote it as well. Moderators, however, keep removing the link because they consider it self-promotion. Now, I think Reddit needs a more nuanced approach to self-promotion because the core function of Reddit is to essentially promote what Redditors like. The current status quo gives all the advantage to celebrities and established brands while it tells the average Redditor that they couldn't possibly create something that other people would value. I think this is an especially relevant discussion given that just this week, Reddit's owners announced the closing of a $50 million round of angel funding and noted that they plan to give 10% of the shares back to the community, quote, in recognition of the central role the community plays in Reddit's ongoing success. Here's my story. My name's James, and you don't recognize me because, like you, I'm just another Reddit user. Last week, I launched a new weekly bundle-style website similar to sites like the Humble Bundle and Stack Social, which sell collections of video games and other digital products for whatever price people want to pay. I'm not going to name my site until the end of this video, but the twist with mine is that it sells really good, underappreciated indie music that you can download for free or pay whatever you want to get, and the money goes to the artists and a charity. It's nothing revolutionary, but it's the kind of website that as a music fan I really wanted to see made. Given the popularity that sites like the Humble Bundle have achieved on Reddit, I plan to submit the link to our music. But instead of just posting the link, I messaged the moderators first. I wanted to be considerate and make sure they didn't see this as me just posting spam. The moderator said no because I'd be using Reddit as a free medium to advertise, and they told me to buy an ad instead. I should note that my site originally had a $1 minimum purchase, which was really short-sighted, and right after this exchange, I removed that so that there's a free download option. And this exchange and that all happened within 48 hours of launch. I also tried taking the mod's advice and buying an ad. $60 later, I had 60,000 impressions on our music and 52 clicks. Worth a shot, but not very effective. I know that I personally very rarely, if ever, click on ads, but I know that I've gone to Reddit and found stuff made by other Redditors that I've really liked and supported via links on the site. I went back to the Our Music moderators to respectfully plead my case and to mention the free download option. As respectfully as possible, I pointed out that websites with the exact same business model as mine had been tremendously popular on Our Music in the past, namely the Humble Music Bundle and a European site called Music Rage. I was just looking for the same opportunity to let people vote up or down on my site. But they said our music's rules have become more strict since the success of the Humble Music Bundle and such links were no longer allowed. Now, I felt like kind of a twat at this point, but I had to ask if they were really planning to block any future links to Humble Music Bundles. It just didn't make any sense. Redditors would want to see that stuff. I would want to see that stuff. So what do you think their response was? Buy an ad. Stop messaging us. Alright, fine. For an experiment, I turned to rindierock, a subreddit with 0.5% the audience of our music. I posted the link just as I would have posted it on our music if given a chance. An hour later, my link was number one on rindierock with 11 upvotes and 0 downvotes. My site was also seeing a spike in free downloads. The only comment was, "This is awesome, thank you." And then, a mod removed the link. I messaged the mods to ask why, seeing as how it didn't violate any rules on the sidebar, and users were clearly liking it. The mod who responded said that another mod likely removed it, assuming it was self-promotion. Now, this other mod restored the link, but it was away from the subreddit for 5 hours. Keep in mind that neither my post nor my message mentioned whether or not I had anything to do with the website. The first mod just assumed that I did, and the second mod assumed that I didn't. While all of this was happening, the top link on our music was literally telling people to go buy the new Thom Yorke album, which is awesome, by the way, and I'm fine with that, but clearly there's a problem when indie musicians can't attempt to even give away their music for free on Reddit, while Thom Yorke gets hundreds of thousands of views in free advertisement. I took the story to ourself, where I asked, has Reddit become a place where celebrities and big brands get a free ride, while up-and-comers with new projects mostly get shut out? I wasn't blaming the mods for this, I think this is a problem that's Reddit-wide, and people overwhelmingly seemed to agree with me when I was writing about it. This was the #3 post on ourself last week. Several people said that it was unreasonable that I couldn't share the link and let our music users decide to vote up or down. One Redditor agreed with me that they couldn't stand the double standard, but noted that promotional posts on Reddit are a tricky topic. I couldn't agree more with that, personally. Another user said that they come to Reddit to find interesting content, self-promoted or not. Another suggested I do an AMA as a loophole. And yet another said that they submitted their own content all the time. If they simply link to it, it gets tons of upvotes and visits. When they mention that they wrote it themselves, it gets downvoted. One Redditor said, "I was technically in the wrong because moderators own their subreddits and are able to remove anything they want." But they also agreed that there was a hypocrisy problem and that Reddit caters more to celebrities and big brands. They just thought there was little to be done about it. Now, I don't disagree about the fact that moderators should be able to control whatever's on the subreddit. I just think it's fair to question the roles of these handfuls of volunteers who control the mainstream subreddits that millions of people see, and therefore control some of the most influential pages on the internet. I should point out that Reddit's own page on Redditkit says that users should feel free to post links to their own content within reason, such as only having one out of every 10 of your submissions be your own content. It also turns out there's potentially more being done about this problem than many of us think. Someone recommended I reach out to the Reddit user The Neutral Party, who's like a super moderator. The dude moderates 44 subreddits, including Awe and Advice Animals. The Neutral Party told me this topic is a gray area, but he enjoys seeing new artists and entrepreneurs sharing their work on Reddit, as long as they contribute more to Reddit than just sharing their own work, i.e. following Redditkit. He also referred me to a discussion on rmodnews, a subreddit where Reddit administrators communicate with moderators. In that discussion, Reddit admin CrispyCrackers says that more and more often, users are creating content that the Reddit community enjoys and wants to consume, but current guidelines make it difficult for the actual creator to be involved in the process. He or she gives several examples and prompts a discussion by the moderators, and the top comment hits the nail on the head. The commenter was fine with all of these examples as long as 1. There's transparency, 2. The point of the subreddit is self-promotion, or 3. The link creates good discussion. They went on to say Reddit is undoubtedly used for advertisement, whether you want to admit it or not, and celebrity AMAs are a perfect example of that. Another user suggested that unless Reddit returns to being more open and free, users will be pushed to move to sites that offer greater freedom. Other users said this sort of anti-community attitude was exactly what led to the death of Dig and brought a flood of Dig users over to Reddit 5 years ago. I include myself among those pilgrims. I was a heavy Dig user and I moved over to Reddit 5 years ago. My 5th cake day is next month. The bottom line is we need to recognize that Reddit users are completely capable of creating content that other users will value, and that content deserves a shot on the site. I wasn't asking the R Music moderators for any special treatment when I messaged them. I was just looking for a shot to have my link voted up or down on the website, the way everything used to work on Reddit. Alright, it's time to plug my website. It's called The Good Pack, and it features 5 really great indie rock and folk acts from my homeland, the Pacific Northwest. You can download their albums for free, or you can choose to buy them all for whatever price you think is fair. If you pay any money, 30% of it will go to Youth Care, a homeless youth center in Seattle. In a way, the site is really relevant to this discussion because it's all about promoting little-known or unheard-of bands. The underdogs. I feel like most of us are underdogs when it comes to trying to be seen or heard on the internet. And so, this is a toast to you. It is my birthday. Thank you for watching. The stuff I'm drinking out of this mug is, in fact, beer. Cheers.